you know, the rigidity is not there, the force is not there to make them account for how units of all that they are producing for, all the locations made, how they were executed. And that's the problem. Because if we say that we wanted malaria to be eradicated, spearheaded by the Ministry of
Health,
and the projection is made and the money is made available, let's assume that the executive is faithful to bring out the money at every time. It's hard for the National Assembly to drive the concerned institution. Whether what is said will be done at the end of the year is done. Was malaria actually induced by what percentage? And then if we have that direct, this is what should have been achieved, whether it was achieved or not, it will help us perform the next thing that should happen in the budget. But we say we don't drive this down sufficiently. We cannot say we budgeted 2 million naira to eliminate malaria, and at the end of that year, the money was not sufficient, or it was enough, or this is how far malaria was eliminated, or this is the percentage that is left. We are not able to come to terms like that when you talk about the budget. If we can do that, a large percentage of the problem will go. Okay, if COVID is a good excuse, if eventual developments in the course of the year are good reasons, did it affect every element in the budget? If we give, for example, 20 billion to, let's call it one of the agencies we have, PCC, to build structures in the country, 20 billion, build two offices or three offices across Nigeria. At the end of the day, did the COVID affect the allocation for them? Did it affect the allocation for everything? So if we drive things down properly, the money allocated for every sector, we can find out whether it solved the problem it was intended to solve or not. So that relationship is still not there. And I think that we need to do something about it. If the National Assembly approves a sum of money for a particular project at the end of the year, can we say that this institution, this ministry, this MDA, this agency actually did what the money was intended for? And we now say that okay, there was a shortfall, it was not sufficient or it was enough. Did we get the outcome that we wanted? If, as long as we don't go for the outcome, we don't know what happened with the money allocated, it's going to be a problem every year. So that's why he was saying that what was allocated for a project last year still shows up in the new project. So somebody must close that gap. That if we say, okay, we need 10 computers for a particular institution to run well, did the federal government provide the funding required? And if it was provided, did they buy the computers they said that they will buy? Somebody should be able to check and come back with the report that, they didn't buy anything, or they bought only 40 instead of 100. And this is why it was 40 instead of 100. If we don't have that, these schemes will keep coming down.
Yes,
report.
Yes, you see, the, I have mentioned something about what that when your report is given about a particular contract, that report should be explicit based on financial reporting standard. Should there be a variation, another contract is given with respect to that. The reporting standard said it must be captured. If it is not captured, then the whole basis of the reporting is rejected. That is the new financial standard regulation. So this thing we do, where we give contracts and we award it again and we conceal, concealment is a fundamental breach of financial regulations. Where there is concealment, it is assumed that that financial statement